greatest pleasure in introducing David Bornstein.
Thank you. Thank you. So, as a journalist, most journalists come off as pretty cynical, but in fact, they went into this work to change the world and to improve the world. And we actually help people understand what the world is. This is what we do every day. But the news has produced such a narrative of brokenness, really over the last 50 years. I mean, this is really what we see. I mean, you see the Twitter feed, you read about what's going on in Washington, or if something blows up. And in fact, we're now contributing, and we have been contributing for a long time, to a lot of fear and anxiety. The United States, the reason why the life expectancy in the United States is going down is because of what they call deaths of despair, largely addiction, alcohol, suicide. This is the former Surgeon General of the United States talked about an epidemic of loneliness in the country. The biggest health problem in the country is loneliness, and it has the health effects of smoking a pack of cigarettes a day if you're severely lonely. So a lot of this has been contributed to this narrative that journalism has created. And as Larry said, we don't have a language for describing winning, for describing good things other than shutting up. And that's not a good thing. So what we've been trying to do is to create that language, a framework to help people understand what the world is really like, and also how we can talk about things that are positive without coming off as sort of fluffy or Pollyannish, or getting people to lose their sense of urgency. I have been a journalist for almost 30 years, and early in my career, I was working for New York Newsday. I covered a lot of murders, and it really depressed me, and I thought I might want to leave journalism. But I switched. I ended up moving into the business of covering international development and really looking at how people around the world were trying to solve social problems. So I spent a year in Bangladesh writing a book looking at how people were providing loans to the poorest people in the world to reduce poverty. And that really had a huge impact on how I saw the poorest people in the world. They were not necessarily just people waiting for marines to throw rice at them out of helicopters when there was a cyclone. They were very competent people, and they had a lot of agency. I went to India, and I reported on how